Hello and welcome to this webinar. My name is Juliana Derciati Magro and I am the OER librarian at the Midtown Library at Touro College. Today I will talk about ORCID, which stands for Open Researcher and Contributor ID. Let's first talk about why you should create an ID such as ORCID. Imagine this is Barbara Miller, a professor and researcher. This professor publishes her research in several papers and attends conferences. She also received grants to develop her research. But she faces some challenges when her institution, grantors, and other researchers try to find a comprehensive list of her accomplishments. And that happens because databases, the internet, and other resources link research outputs with the researcher's name. Names can change over time and can be expressed in different ways. This is the main problem that ORCID's trying to solve. ORCID IDs are unique and persistent identifiers. They're created and used by researchers and scholars, and they solve name ambiguity. Much like ISBN for books or digital identifiers or DOIs for digital objects such as articles, ORCID generates a number so that the author can be identified using that particular string of numbers. This number ID can be attached to any new research output, such as the article shown here in this page. After each researcher's name, there's an ORCID logo in green. Clicking on that number will link you to the author's ORCID page. It is important to note that you are in control of what is shown in your public profile and what is private. Here is one example of an ORCID ID. You'd have a biography, your employment history, your ORCID ID number here, which is also a hyperlink, and other name variations. You can add your websites, have keywords that are related to your research, and if you have different IDs, you can also add that. And you can list all your works. ORCID identifiers are non-proprietary, and there is no fee to maintain yours. They're not tied to your place of work or host institution, and you control what information gets linked to or displays in your ORCID profile. The registry isn't a social network. Your ORCID profile simply displays the activities, education, employment, and funding you add or approve from trusted organizations. Having your ORCID ID means that all your papers, datasets, grants will have the ID identifying you to that research output. In the case of our previous example, Barbara Miller, she would not have to worry about being mistaken by other researcher also named Barbara Miller or something similar. As mentioned, the same ID can continue to be used even if the researcher goes to a different institution, a different country, or even a different field altogether. Some reasons to use ORCID: some publishers and funders now require them because of name disambiguation, improved work discoverability, minimized data entry in publication and grant application workflows, asserts authorship over works, and because grants, scholarships, and other projects will be all in one place. It takes about 30 seconds to register to ORCID. All you have to do is sign up on that website and verify your email address. Then you can add your info and add your publication article. And then you can use on your website and grant applications and publication submissions. You can also add your ORCID ID to your email signature. If you go to ORCID.org, this is what you will see. All you have to do is click on Register Now, which will lead you to the following page. Fill out your information and set your visibility settings. Thank you. If you have any questions, please go to the library website and chat with a librarian, or you can also email me.